since the earliest days of video arcades, gamers have measured how they're doing by keeping track of their score. In coding, when you need your computer to remember an important piece of information, like score, lives, health, or inventory, you need to store that information in a special location where the computer will be able to find it again when it's needed. These little baskets for storing information are called variables. You can store any kind of information you want in a variable. A number, like your age or the current temperature. A word, like banana or balloon. Or a combination of the two, like January 27th. They're called variables because the value, the information stored in the cubbyhole, can change or vary while your program runs. You can create as many variables as you like in Scratch. All you have to do is pick a name that describes the kind of information you want to store inside it. Once you've created the variable, a little box pops up on your screen to show you what the current value of that variable is. You can set the value of a variable using this block. Every time this block is executed, it will fill up your memory basket with the information you entered in this blank space. If the information you stored is a number, you can use this block to change it. For example, if my variable for health says 50, I can click on this block, and every time I do, it will go up by 1 to 51, 52, and so on. I can also make it go down by entering a negative number. Now that we know all about variables, let's go ahead and add one to our game. The variable we're looking to change here, of course, is our score. Let's go ahead and create a score variable by clicking on the darker orange bubble near the bottom left of the screen. There's already a default variable here called my variable, but we want to create a brand new one by clicking on this white button that says make a variable. Let's give our new variable a name. We'll call it score. We don't have to worry about any of these other advanced options, so just click OK. So a little box has appeared at the top of the screen to tell us what the current score is, but our code blocks don't look any different. To find our score variable, you're going to have to hold down this white options arrow and you'll see a list of all the variables you've created. When you're using variables blocks, it's important to make sure you're changing the right variable. I've lost count of the number of times a student has told me their score isn't working when the variable they're actually changing is my variable instead of score. Clicking on this block does nothing, but when I change the variable to score, it starts working the way I expect. So where do I put this block in my code? What's the event in our game that's going to make the score change? We want our score to change every time we eat a mouse, which means we'll have to put this block in our if statement, which is already waiting for the mice to collide with the cat. But which of these two blocks should I insert in the loop? Do I want to set the score or change it? You've probably already guessed the answer, but let's try a little experiment just to be sure. If I set the score to 10 and play the game, you'll see that the first time I eat a mouse, the score does indeed go up by 10, but then it stops working. Every time the set score block is activated, it sends a message saying the score is now equal to 10. It will keep being equal to 10 no matter how many mice you catch. If I substitute a change score, the score changes by 10 points every time I eat a mouse. Here's another spot where you get to customize your game. How many points do you want to score every time you eat a mouse? I'm going to go with 10 points per mouse, but you can change your score by 1, 10, 100, or even a million if that's what floats your boat. Let's test our game. Everything appears to be working great, but if I stop the game and restart it, you'll notice that the score doesn't reset itself. To get the score back to zero again, we're going to have to use the set variable command to bring the score back down to its starting position. Let's put it right under the green flag so the score resets to zero at the moment we start the game. And you can see that our score is resetting each time I click the green flag. Okay, teachers, get your earplugs ready, because when we return, I'm going to teach you how to add sound effects to your game.